If you've driven around Greensboro or Jamestown, perhaps you've seen one of these signs, David Walks 2019. They aren't political or even promoting an event. It's just a group of people letting a guy named David know they're praying for him and they believe in him. In August 2017, David Dyson was a young dad, a landscaper, and the life of the party. But then he dove into shallow water, just as he'd done hundreds of times before. This time, though, he broke his neck, leaving him a quadriplegic. Now David is determined to walk again, and he has an army of people encouraging him every step of the way. David Dyson is on a mission.
Every day.
It's Monday. We're at the Jamestown Y.
At least twice a day.
We're back at the gym.
Monday through Friday.
From hitting the gym at the Y in Jamestown to oxygen therapy in Durham and gait training in Charlotte, he's made getting better and getting up his full-time job.
Most certainly, 100%, I think that I will walk again. That's been my goal since I woke up after surgery.
David crushed his C5 vertebrae in a diving accident in 2017, leaving him a quadriplegic. Everything about life changed for him and his wife, Katie, and their son, Carson, who was just a toddler at the time.
It's almost been 2.5 years since David's accident. It's the grief of, you know, losing this former life you had is really hard.
But there is joy.
Let's go faster.
And a lot of it.
Faster. Get on a straightaway there.
With Katie at his side, David has relearned a lot from the major accomplishments like playing with his son.
Can you honk the horn?
To the more mundane tasks.
So did you have to get these made? Or is it...
Somebody already has these made.
Like holding silverware.
The doctors have never said that David won't walk again because they don't know. You know, that the spinal cord is what they know least about in the body.
It's why David says he'll never give up.
Tuesday.
Until he gets his miracle.
David Walton, 2019.
When you sit at home, it can be a little bit depressing. But when you get out and you move and you try, at least I can go to bed knowing that I tried.
And thanks to so many signs of hope, it's a journey they find just a little easier to navigate.
It's just very, very, very encouraging, and it keeps me wanting to go.
Now, that army of supporters I mentioned is holding a fundraiser tomorrow night in honor of the Dysons. They want to raise money to help David get some of his independence back, starting with a special van that he would be able to drive. If you would like to drop by, the fundraiser is happening at Sedgefield Country Club tomorrow night from 6 until 8.
We certainly send him all of our best wishes. I've loved seeing those signs out in the community. All right, it's a debate lighting up a neighborhood here in North Carolina.